Hello everyone, so welcome to my YouTube channel. So in this video, let's see how we can just can create a EC2 instance. So I have logged in to my AWS management console here. So to look for EC2 instance services, we can just search here as EC2. Okay, so we can just click on to this EC2, that is virtual server in the cloud, or else if we have recently accessed, okay, we can just click on to this EC2, or else like in the services tab, you can just click on to this EC2. Okay, so you have so many ways. Okay, so how we can just get into this EC2 instance creation page. Okay, so let's go to the EC2. So once you have just get into EC2, okay, so this is all the instances which is currently running here, right? You can see this is the name of the instance, this is the state, then the instance type. So you can see all the basic details over here. So let's go and create very simple EC2 instance, okay? So so that we'll understand like how we can just launch. Then we'll see other examples like with the user data and how to launch and all those other instances types. Okay, so once you click on to this launch instance, I'll just show you. Okay, so you can just click on to this launch instances. So first step is to choose an Amazon machine image. Okay, you can see like we have a 7 steps here, starting with choosing AMI. Then we need to choose the instance type, then configure then we need to configure an instance which I've just selected. Then if you want to add the storage, then the tags, then finally the security group, and finally we'll review whatever the option we have chosen, and then finally we can just create our instance. So our first step is to choose the Amazon machine image. So we have a different options here, so based on so whatever the account type you have. Okay, so here like for example, like for the free tier eligible, we have only this two options, right? So Amazon Linux 2 AMI, and we have Amazon Linux 2 AMI with the different kernel version. Okay, so let's start with this. Okay, let's select this. Okay, for the 64-bit. So here in the step 2, so we need to choose an instance type. Okay, so we have a different families here, so based on your requirement. Okay, so you can just select. So right now, if you are into the free tier eligible and you are just practicing it, so you need to select this, that is T2 micro. So here, so you have the CPU 1 and memory is 1 GB. Okay, and instance storage is EBS. And the network performance, you can see it's low to moderate. So now let's go to the next step. So I've just selected this. Okay, so let's go to the configuration instance. So if I want, so number of instances right now it's 1. Okay, so if you are enabling the auto scaling, okay, so we can just click onto this, but right now we'll keep it very simple. So now the number of instances is just 1. So next we have a network subnet. You can see it's already created by default, so we'll not change this. So and one more, we have an option called user data. Okay, so we can, so as we are launching the instance, okay, we can give the user data. Okay, so right now we'll not give, but in the next video we'll create one more instance using the user data, fine. So let's keep it default, so I'll not make any changes here. So next, click on to this add storage. So here, so if you want to attach a new volume, okay, so you can just click on this add new volume and attach the storage to this instance. So right now, so here it has created a volume. Type is root, okay, and the size is 8 GB, and the volume type, it is general purpose. Okay, so you can see like we have a different volume types here, so I've just I'll just go with the default one, and it's not encrypted. Okay, so finally next is add tags. Okay, so if you want to add tags to this instance, you can just add tags over here. Okay, so let's go to the security group. So it's basically a set of firewall rules that control the traffic to your instance, right? So right now it is SSH. So if you want to add rule like HTTPS or HTTP, you can just add it over here. Okay, so as I told you, so we'll keep it simple. So let's go with SSH. Okay, so let's go click on review and launch. So in the review and launch, so finally we are in the step 7. Okay, so where we can review all the options and configurations which I've just chosen. So everything is set, and let's go and click on launch. So this is a very important step, okay? So if you are creating an instance for the first time, to access this instance, okay, so if you are doing SSH, okay, you even you require this key pair, okay? So if you are doing it for the first time, okay, you can just create a new key pair value here. So I'll just create a new key pair value, and you need to give the key pair name, okay? So I'll just give a demo, and I'll just download the key pair. So you can see, so a key pair consists of public key that AWS stores and the private key file that you store, okay? And together they allow you to connect your instances securely. So if you have already have existing key pair, you can just use that key pair and connect your instance. But yeah, so if you want to secure instance, okay, you can just create a new key pair value and you can just download it, okay? It will be in the form of .pm file, okay? So let's click on launch instance. So your instance are now running. So our instance has got created. So if I just click on to the view launch log, okay, so you can see everything is successful. So if I just go back to my EC2. You can see the key pair value, that is demo Imran, this is what our instance is. So you can just give the name here to your instance, okay? So here I can just give name. So here you can access all the basic details like about your instance ID, and more importantly, which we require is public IPv4 address and the private IPv4 address. And you can view all your security details, networking, storage, status check, monitoring, and the tags. Okay, so this is how it's very simple. So within a few minutes, we have created instance in the Amazon, right? To explore more about this, like about the different options, how you can just connect with instance, and about the different actions, okay, so we'll be seeing in upcoming videos. So I hope you have understood, okay? So if you have any doubts, you can just ask me in the comments.